For a still image, the overall mesh layout mostly doesn't matter, just as long as the render looks good. However, once animation starts, the mesh topology can have a significant impact on the shape and form of the character as polygons are deformed. This issue is usually most noticeable at joints, with some being more complex than others, but all of them being different in some way. For this video, let's initially focus on one of the easiest joints, the elbow. The most basic elbow joint you can have is one with just a single edge loop. Of course, even with a subdivision modifier, this is clearly no good, as the elbow just largely bends and collapses in on itself. What is needed are supporting edge loops that will help to maintain the overall shape while providing more geometry in the deforming area. Already things are looking a lot better, with the overall arm holding most of its shape and the main bending happening at the joint. However, on the outside of the geometry, it is being stretched too far, while on the inside it is being compressed too much. This is why you ideally want any topology to be closer together in areas that will be pulled apart, while being further away in any areas that are being pressed together. By making that change in the default rest position, we start to get a more even distribution of polygons as the elbow bends. However, this brings us to the next challenge, combining form with function. The elbow isn't just a straight pipe, various bones and muscles affect its shape, but this still needs to be applied within the overall topology of the mesh, so that once it's deformed, not only does the animation look good, but the shape and form still look correct. With the basic topology now sorted out, it's time to refine the overall edge loops to see if we can make it better. By compressing the part that gets deformed the most, it's possible to hold a bit more of the shape at the funny bone. However, you can start to notice that the overall upper and lower arm is folding into itself too much. What is needed are additional edge loops that can help to keep the shape at the point where the arm is bending and collapsing together. Now things are starting to look a lot better, as we almost get the impression of muscles at work here. Finally, within the whole topology structure, some more mesh details can be added. As such, the elbow is now basically done. However, I'm sure you have all noticed a problem. Just about the whole time the elbow has been very rounded as it bends. Hence, it doesn't look anywhere near as good as this final version, and that is because topology can't solve everything. This is important, and the reason I'm planning a whole series of videos around character creation. Looking at these three videos, the overall deformation is clearly different, from bad to good to better. However, they all have the exact same base topology. The difference is the second video has preserved volume turned on in the armature modifier. This has largely been turned on for all of the previous elbow deformation samples as well. With it active, the elbow no longer collapses into itself, however, it does make for a very rounded end during bending. Which brings us to another modifier, and that is corrective smooth. Once this is added to the stack, we still have our overall volume maintained, but it's no longer bulging out at the elbow. This is why, like with so much in 3D, it is important to understand and follow the process. Each step builds on the previous, and unless you have years or decades of experience, it's hard to know how something is going to turn out in the end. Hence, the sooner you can test each step with at least some basic configuration of the following stages, the better the final result will be. Future videos will go into this in more detail, along with seeing how to apply what's been covered to areas like fingers, knees, and shoulders. So make sure to subscribe and hit like so you don't miss out on the next character creation installment, and I hope to see you then. Cheers!